Let's begin with a spiritual mind treatment or affirmative prayer. So I just invite you to recognize the truth with me that this really is a spiritual universe, that each one of us is a spiritual being having a human experience, living as one with the one, the oneness, the universal divine givingness. And understanding this and feeling connected to spirit itself, let us also celebrate the fact that we are so connected to each other. That we have come here this morning to celebrate that divine connection, that oneness, and that good now is in demonstration right here in this center and for each of us and for every person with whom we are connected, whether they are physically present with us today or not. This feeling of connection is an awareness of love itself. I give thanks for the truth and the understanding that each of us is the center of love in an infinite consciousness, an infinite mind of good, of love, of loving kindness. Knowing this, I relax and know that good now unfolds. I give thanks for this good. I know that each of us recognizes it in so many ways. We are alert and open to good here, now, and always. Knowing this is so, I turn this treatment over to Spirit, understanding and giving thanks that it is already done, and inviting you to know this with me and to acknowledge it by saying with me, and so it is.
Good God morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Well, this is weekend we're remembering. So, I'm going to do something. There are places I remember all my life, though some have changed, some forever, not for better. Some are gone, and some remain. All these places have their moments with lovers and friends. I still can recall some are dead and some are living. In my life, I've loved them all. But of all these friends and lovers, there is no one compares with you. And these memories lose their meaning when I think of love as something new. Though I know I'll never lose affection for people and things that went before, I know I'll often stop and think about them. In my life, I love you more. Thank you. In my life, I love you more.
Thanks for being with us, Rick.
My pleasure.
And I'm Reverend Kate, and it is my great pleasure to welcome everyone to the Center for Spiritual Living this morning, where we really remind ourselves every week that there is a power for good in the universe and that we can use it. So to start with, I'd like to invite Robert up to help us light our candles. And we, as we do this, I guess this is a memory thing too. We're reminding ourselves of the underlying spirit of life and the divine unity of all. So first we light a candle for life. Life is everywhere present, flowing through each and every one of us. There is only one life. That life is God's life. That life is our life now. So please affirm with me, I am life. We light a candle for love. The birth of love happens within each one of us every time we make room for the Christ consciousness in our hearts and recognize our unity. We are points of love within the heart of God. So please affirm with me, I am love. We light a candle for light. The light of God is the presence and the power. We are always walking in the light. We radiate the light of God wherever we are. Please affirm with me, I am light. We light a candle for beauty. We are made in the likeness and image of God, so we are each whole, complete, and beautiful just as we are. We accept the beauty of God's perfection as our perfection now. Please affirm with me, I am beauty. And we light a candle for joy. Joy is the very nature of spirit and the true essence of each of us. We celebrate the joy of our own rebirth in the God consciousness. We each bring joy to the world. Please affirm with me, I am joy. We light the candle for peace. Today and every day, we open our hearts to peace. We are each a center of peace in our world. So please affirm with me, I am peace. And finally, I invite you to take a moment and recognize your own inner light that is always shining within as we each honor our own metaphysical path of wholeness, oneness, and mental healing through the practice of universal spiritual principles. Thank you, Robert. So I have a few other announcements that I want to share. First, I want to welcome, I'm sort of laughing because it's like, we have a new visitor that's unexpected, which is practitioner Larry is babysitting his daughter's talk. So, but for you human visitors, I really want to especially welcome you, and especially if it's your first time here, please make yourself at home and stay for fellowship after the service and sign our guest book in the lobby. And know that every Sunday we do offer spiritual mind treatment or affirmative prayer as our gift to you. So if you have a prayer request today, you can either speak to me, Reverend Lori, Reverend Maureen, Practitioner Robert. Practitioner Larry is going to be perfect if you're a dog lover. And we'll be happy to do a affirmative prayer one-to-one on your behalf. Or if you want, you can just put in a written request and put it in the wooden box in the lobby. And then our prayer team will do treatment for you during the week. Oh, let's see. Today we're just having fellowship. And then afterwards, we're going to have a brief meeting of our site committee. So we'll meet in the back corner in this room. So as you all know, this is truly a community-based spiritual center. And we really have thanks. I mean, we're here thanks to all of you. So today, let's show some appreciation for these beautiful flowers. Thank you, Ruth Ann. To Jan Green for being our greeter. Thank you, Jan. To Nikki for bringing treats. To Jim for doing setup and video recording. So thank you. And, oh yeah, my son Dave, who's not here, but he also did the setup this morning. So, yeah, that's good. And of course, the volunteer sheet is right in the lobby if you'd like to sign up. So now, if you could look inside your program and find the group reading. Does anyone need a program? We're good. Or you have it memorized? Please read it aloud with me. God is all, both visible and invisible, one presence, one mind, one power is all. This one that is all is perfect love and perfect abundance. I am an individualized expression of God. I am ever one with this perfect life, perfect love, and perfect abundance. So now, if you'd like to stand, we'll have a group song.
Well, one of God's greatest gifts is the gift of choice. And who wants to choose heaven today? Okay.
Good morning again. Okay, so this morning's reading is from an essay by Ralph Waldo Emerson, who went by his middle name Waldo, was an American essayist, lecturer, philosopher, abolitionist, and poet who led the Transcendentalist movement of the mid-19th century. He was a major influence on the New Thought movement and one of the main influences on Ernest Holmes. His essay. The characteristic of heroism is its persistency. All men have wandering impulses, fits and starts of generosity. But when you have chosen your part, abide by it, and do not weakly try to reconcile yourself with the world. The heroic cannot be the common, nor the common the heroic. Yet we have the weakness to expect the sympathy of people in those actions whose excellence is that they outrun sympathy and appeal to a tardy justice. If you would serve your brother because it is fit for you to serve him, do not take back your words when you find that prudent people do not commend you. Adhere to your own act and congratulate yourself if you have done something strange and extravagant and broken the monotony of a decorous age. It was a high counsel that I once heard given to a young person. Always do what we are afraid to do. Mm-hmm. And so it is.
Well, on this weekend of remembrance, I'm going to try to remember a song by Harry Nilsson that you may remember. It's called Remember. Long ago, far away, life was clear. Close your eyes. Remember, is a place from long ago. Remember, filled with everything you know. Remember, when you're sad and feeling down. Remember, turn around. Remember, life is just a memory. Remember, close your eyes and you can see. Remember, think of all that life can be. Remember. Dream, love is only in a dream. Remember. Is never as it seems. Dream. Thank you.
Also known as Remembrance Day, and thank you for commemorating it with me. Tomorrow is actually the federal designated day, and where we honor all those who died as a result of war, our heroes, men and women who made the ultimate sacrifice. Today we remember them not just as a three-day holiday, but we remember courage, we remember sacrifice. And to do this, I'm gonna suggest we do some practicing the presence tomorrow. But John 15, scripture, verse 13 states, no one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. Mark Twain said, our heroes are men who do things which we recognize that we can't do. If everybody was satisfied with himself, there'd be no heroes. But before I get into this, you know, I believe the universe has a sense of humor. Otherwise, why would we be here? No. So why does the military plant trees every year? Well, to increase the infant trees. Okay. Did you hear about the accident out at Camp Pendleton? A tank ran over a box of popcorn and killed two colonels. Oh, I know that was, okay, one more. On Memorial Day, a minister noticed little Monica was staring up at the large plaque out in the foyer, and the plaque was covered with names and small American flags. And the 12-year-old had been staring at the plaque. And so the minister walked up and said, well, good morning, Monica. She said, good morning. What is this? Well, the minister replied, it's a memorial to all the men and women who died in the service. And they stood there for a while, a little bit of silence. And finally, Monica said, which service? The 9 o'clock or the 11 o'clock. So each of you should have gotten a little red poppy. It basically symbolizes Memorial Day in 1914 at the start of the war, World War I. There were so many places that were bombed out and there was nothing left except for these little poppies would grow. So that's been sort of a symbol of resilience and symbol of Memorial Day. They're sold to raise funds for widows, orphans, and veterans. It used to be called Decoration Day, and back in 1868, it was started with people laying flowers on the graves of Confederate soldiers. And it was chosen primarily because by May 30th, there are a lot of blooming flowers, but it's also a day that no Civil War battle was fought. Now, as the U.S. moved from Civil War to World War I, they broadened it and called it Memorial Day. And in 1968, it was moved to the last Monday in May. Just wanted to give you some sobering statistics. 4,400 people were lost in the American Revolution, 619,000 in the Civil War, which is more than all our wars combined. 116 in World War I, 405 in World War II, 58,000 in Vietnam, 6,000 in Iraq. That doesn't include people who died from suicide or came home as junkies. So living in Pearl City, of course, we had a large military presence with the Pacific Fleet located there. And every year, my co-employees and myself, we would make leis. And I don't know if you've ever made a lei. You have a long needle. It's just like this. It's a long wire. And you put the flowers on it. And women all over the island of Oahu do this. We used to pick the plumeria, pink, red, and white. And we would lay the leis on the graves in Punch Bowl. Punch Bowl Crater is it's a volcanic crater, and it used to be used by King Kamehameha. The first non-Hawaiian to be interred there was in 1949. There's another famous cemetery, Arlington National. 300,000 veterans of every American conflict, from the Revolutionary War to Afghanistan, are buried there. Then there's a Vietnam Memorial, the Wall, which was built in Washington, D.C. And there's also the Three Servicemen statue. If you've been there, there's also the Vietnam Women's Memorial. I've also visited the one in California and Sacramento. it names all the California men and women who died. It's downtown on 15th Street, right behind the state capitol. So next time you're there. So it's important to remember. I come from a proud family. My grandfather was a sergeant in World War II in the trenches. My father was in the Navy, the first LST, which is a landing ship, to hit the beach at D-Day, on D-Day at Normandy. I had two cousins who were drafted, and one came home with an addiction, and he died very early. So I want to talk a little bit about a hero, important hero to me. In the summer of 1970, I was stationed at Fort McClellan, Alabama. I had signed up for basic training in the Women's Army Corps, and they used to be segregated. Men and women did not serve together in the same outfits. I was on track. I was a student at UCLA, but I was taking the program during the summer. And if I passed all the tests and did all the training, I was going to be offered a commission. And there were many other women like me from all over the world, really Guam, Hawaii, who were lower income, but they were looking for to advance and do something for their countries. So toward the end of my training, 2 days left in my training, I received a phone call, which is very unusual because we didn't have cell phones then, but there were no phones in the barracks. And my CO came to me and said, "You need to call home. It's an emergency." So I called. My mom said Greg Keller had rolled over on a mine and been killed. He had only been in the Marine Corps about 2 months. He and my brother were best buddies. They were on the wrestling team, and they had just graduated from high school. My brother got a scholarship and was going to go on to UCLA, and Greg always wanted to join the Marine Corps. He was the California State Wrestling Champ from Lowell High School in La Habra, California. And he didn't care for a scholarship. He was excited about joining. Now, Eleanor Roosevelt said, True patriotism springs from a belief in the dignity of the individual, freedom and equality, not only for Americans, but for all people on earth. So after 2 days after the call, I went back to California. I did not accept a commission. And I remained in inactive duty for about 18 months, but it was a very conflicting time for me. I think most people at this time were conflicted. And the race consciousness in the US changed. We were out of Saigon by 1975. But Greg, to me, is my hero. He gave the gift of life. He was an example of selfless being. And he felt that joining the Marine Corps was the highest and best thing he could do. And I honor his decision. So originally I was sad and I was mad. But then I read Ernest Holmes on mortality. And Ernest said, the plane upon which we are now living with its form of matter is probably one of immeasurable places, each having its own manner with its own corresponding form. The resurrection body is already within us. If today is the logical continuance of yesterday, then all of the tomorrows which stretch down the vista of eternity will be a continuity of experiences and remembrances when we realize the eternity of our own being. He's saying we're immortal. And he went on to say, nature will not let us stay in one place too long. She'll let us stay just long enough to gather the experience that we need for the unfolding and the advancement of the soul. And if you compare it to a birth of a baby, you know, baby passes from a single dimension in the dark in the womb, out into the world, and into the three dimensions. So I believe death is of this world is a birth into an even greater dimension. And it's interesting, Jesus said, let your heart not be troubled. He said, in my Father's house are many mansions. Now, I've seen a translation from the Aramaic, and it says, in my Father's house there are many dimensions. So, back to World War I, something interesting happened that they don't talk about, especially not the COs, the commanding officers. During the first Christmas, December 1914, with forces, British and German, separated by no man's land, littered with fallen comrades, sounds of a German Christmas carol, Stille Nacht, which is Silent Night. Soldiers had been killing each other by the tens of thousands for months, and they climbed out of the trenches, out of their muddy, soggy trenches, and they reached across a narrow divide, and presents were exchanged. Now, this is where the poppies came from, Flanders Field, a century ago. A spontaneous Christmas truce lifted the human spirit. It was momentary because that war continued for 4 more years, but many soldiers exchanged small gifts. And I believe peace was attempting to break out. It just took a little time. So to find peace, we have to change our thinking, and sometimes we have to look at what we're doing. If we're in war, maybe it's time for peace. Maybe it's time to turn away. Now, a very famous theoretical physicist named Max, in English we say Planck, Max Planck, he was a German theoretical physicist, and he said, if you change the way you look at things, the things you look at change. And of course, he was one of the fathers of quantum physics. And Mark Twain Well, and we say that. We say, change your thinking, change your life. Change how you see war. You know, see it as peace. Mark Twain said about war, he said, all war must be just the killing of strangers against whom you feel no personal animosity. Strangers whom, in other circumstances, you would help if you found them in trouble, and who would help you if you needed it. Gandhi said, we'll not learn how to live together in peace by killing each other's children. So I believe we've learned all we need to learn about war. It's time to learn about peace. So tomorrow, when you celebrate, the national movement has a 3 o'clock local time. Everyone in the country celebrates a moment of silence. So I have an idea. you can visit the cemeteries and put lays or flowers or bouquets on them. That's good. Think about the people we've lost. Think about our loved ones. But it's important to also stop and think about peace, because we've been doing a class by a fellow named, Emmett Fox. Emmett Fox. He was a very famous writer. We have a couple of his books out there. But we were taking a class called Mental Equivalence, which is in your mind. We do the work first in our mind to create before we see it in reality. He wrote another pamphlet. It was called How to Bring About Peace. And he suggests every day for 5 minutes, if you did this, you would change the consciousness of the world. So there's no time like tomorrow to start doing it, or today to start doing it. He said, you have the power to change the consciousness of the world. He called it a scientific method. We call it affirmative prayer, or we call it spiritual mind treatment. But he said, practice the presence. That means the presence, whatever the presence is to you, God, whatever you want to call it. Declare that God is fully present in every man, every woman, and every child, in every country on the globe. We can start with Russia, Ukraine, Israel, Palestine, the United States, China, Africa, Germany. It goes on and on. But he says, do this. And he also said, turn away from the news. Turn off the news. Don't listen to what's going on with wars. Don't put it in the consciousness. Just do this. So, we are metaphysicians. We know how to change our life for the better. We know how to use power for good. And we can do that. So, join me tomorrow, today. I'll give a little closing treatment. And just join me remembering these fallen heroes, these fallen soldiers, and all the people that were also impacted and died as a result of these wars. And give peace a chance. Now, a very famous warrior named Sitting Bull, he said, warriors are not what you think of as warriors. A warrior is not someone who fights, for no one has the right to take another life. The warrior for us is the one who sacrifices themselves for the good of others. Their task is to take care of the elderly, the defenseless, those who cannot provide for themselves. Above all, the children, the future of humanity. And as Charles Fillmore said, this is yours to do. This is yours to do. When you wake up tomorrow morning, what is mine to do today? This is yours to do. Co-create peace. So I would like to just speak the names of a few heroes and warriors. And I'll go around, and if you'd like to speak the name of a hero, warrior, I speak my word for the nameless and the unknown soldiers and civilians who have died in war. I speak my word for Greg Keller, for Lawrence Lee, for Willie Lee James, for Stephen Goldstein, for Thomas Sweeney, and Billy Batsloff. Anyone else speak your word?
I speak my word for Will Latimer.
I speak my word for Joseph Brown.
Thank you. And you can silently speak your word for those that are fallen, have left us, but are always, always in the mind. So I just want to say thank you to all of our warriors and all of our heroes. Thank you, and peace be with you. Yes.
I don't know if it's true or not, but somebody told me that the sentence attributed to God that is repeated the most often in the Old Testament is, "Do not be afraid." And I don't know who it was who said this, but he said, the true soldier does not hate what is in front of him. He loves what is behind him. And so I'd like to do this song, and you've probably heard it, and you're welcome to join me if you so desire. For all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, but at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston and New York to LA. Well, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say that I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the man who died and gave that right to me. And I'd gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. To be an American, but at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I'd gladly stand up next to you and
defend us till today. There ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the
today. Just put it in your hand, maybe on your heart. Just give gratitude and know that the giving is receiving, that this is a circulation of love, circulation of energy, spirit, through us, as us. And I give great gratitude that we have the ability to be abundant, to be prosperous. I know it's so, and so it is. Thank you. We're going to sing. I am so blessed.
I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful for all that I have. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful for all that I have. I am so blessed. I am so blessed. I am so grateful. I am so blessed.
Thank you, Rick. And before we do our closing song, I have a prayer for world peace that was written by Ernest Holmes. So if you'd like to just take a moment and close your eyes, and we'll go through this, I'll read this spiritual mind treatment. So take a deep breath. Oh, just know. Ernest Holmes says, I know there is but one God, one mind, which is the mind of God in which all people live and move and have their being. I know there's a divine pattern for humanity, and within this pattern there is infinite harmony and peace, cooperation, unity, and mutual helpfulness. I know that the mind of humankind, being one with the mind of God, shall discover the method, the way, and the means best fitted to permit the flow of divine love between individuals and nations. Harmony, peace, cooperation, unity, and mutual helpfulness are experienced by all. I know there will be a free interchange of ideas, of cultures, of spiritual concepts, of ethics, of educational systems, and scientific discoveries. For all good belongs to all alike. I know that because divine mind has created us all. We are bound together in one infinite and perfect unity. I know that all people and all nations will remain individual, but unified for the common purpose of promoting peace, happiness, harmony, and prosperity. I know that deep within each person, the divine pattern of perfect peace is already implanted. I now declare that in every person and leaders of thought everywhere, this divine pattern moves into action and form to the end that all nations and all people will live together in peace, harmony, and prosperity forever. So it is. So please stand with me and we'll sing our closing song.
Open your heart, let your love go free. Out over the ocean, right across the street. Let it flow like a river, let it fly like a dove. Till your heart remembers, you can't stop love. Once you get it started, watch what it does. It'll go full circle. You can't stop love. Open your heart, let your love go free. Out over the ocean, right across the stream. Let it flow like a river, let it fly like a dove. Till your heart remembers, you can't stop love. Once you get it started, watch what it does. It'll go full circle, you can't stop love.